Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture series of sensors and transducer. In this session I'll be discussing about the thermoelectric transducers. Let us understand the working, construction and the detailed operation on thermoelectric transducer. And finally I'll be enlisting the applications of thermoelectric transducer. So what do you mean by thermoelectric transducer? Let's understand the definition. Thermoelectric transducer elements transform changes of the measured value, that means temperature, to change in either current or voltage arising from difference in temperature at junction of two dissimilar metals in which there is a Seebeck effect. In fact, thermoelectric transducers operate on the principle of Seebeck effect. For that purpose, we require two dissimilar metals, as I mentioned a bit early. Two dissimilar metal has to be connected, and one will act as hot junction and another will act as cold junction. And you can able to measure the temperature in terms of output voltage. So cold junction need to be calibrated. You can able to see there are two dissimilar metal, metal number one and metal number two. And this will act as a junction, one junction temperature. This will act as another junction. Okay, one will act as a hot junction. Say, let us say this is hot junction, other will act as a cold junction. Okay, definitely the difference in temperature that will produce electrical EMF. Okay, so you can able to see one will act as cold junction, another will act as hot junction, and you will be getting the electrical output. So the temperature here, temperature has to be measured. So temperature is the parameter, temperature has to be measured. So difference in hot junction and cold junction, so that will directly proportional to the EMF generated. For example, there is a permanent magnet moving coil galvanometer. So you can able to get either in terms of EMF or in terms of current. Okay, that is a specialty of thermoelectric transducer. It obeys the principle of Seebeck effect. Okay, so this is the way one of the transducer which will be measuring the temperature. Okay, so input is temperature and output will be EMF. That's a specialty of thermoelectric transducer. Here one more diagram which depicts the Seebeck effect. You can able to say that there are two temperature junction T1 and T2, and A and B both are dissimilar metal. So whenever you are connecting two dissimilar metal in this fashion, with one is acting as hot junction, another will act as cold junction, the EMF is directly proportional to S into delta T. And if you remove the proportionality constant, I'll be getting EMF is equal to minus S into delta T. So what is S? S is known as Seebeck coefficient. I'll be letting you know the values of Seebeck coefficient for different junctions. Seebeck coefficient will be varying with respect to the different junctions. There are different junctions like J, T, S. Likewise, there are different junctions that I'll let you know at the end of the session. Delta T is nothing but the difference in temperature. Okay. So how you are going to measure the temperature? You know, there is one unknown temperature that I have to measure. Anyway, I know another junction temperature that you will take it as a reference temperature. So one is unknown, other will act as a reference. So you will be computing the difference in temperature. So that difference in temperature, that is directly proportional to EMF. Okay, the temperature difference is directly proportional to EMF. So let me call it as delta T, change in temperature, that is directly proportional to EMF. So that is a specialty of thermoelectric transducer. It obeys the principle of Seebeck effect. I hope you have studied Seebeck effect in PU classes and plus two classes. Anyway, this is the principle of a thermoelectric transducer. I'll be showing you how you are going to measure the temperature. So I need to measure the temperature of the heat source. This has to be measured. That's my ultimate goal. So you are going to arrange iron wire as well as a copper wire. So this will act as a junction, metal junctions. One will act as hot junction, another will act as a cold junction. Okay, so you are going to join two dissimilar metal in this fashion. You are keeping the temperature, heat source nearby that particular dissimilar metal. Okay, so the difference, one will act as a hot junction, another will act as cold junction. The difference in temperature, that will be directly indicating the EMF. Okay, the delta T is directly proportional to EMF. So this is a setup how you are going to measure the difference in temperature in terms of EMF. I hope you have understood how it is going to operate. So mainly the difference in temperature, that is directly proportional to EMF, okay, output voltage. So thermoelectric effect is used in thermocouples. So that's a peculiarity. You know that there are different combinations. I'll be showing you different combination. One, for example, iron and constant A. Okay. Constant A is nothing but the alloy of copper and nickel. Next is chromel. Chromel is the alloy of chromium and nickel. Then alumel. Alumel is the alloy of aluminium and nickel. So these are the different combinations. Do remember, these are the different combination. Only possible if you arrange this combination. Instead of that, if you are going for different combination, it never be possible to create a thermocouple. So thermocouple is mandatory for thermoelectric transducer. Okay. So thermocouple, that is the main thing which are regarding thermoelectric transducer. Okay. So you have to create these kind of junctions, then only thermocouple will be operated. Now I'll be showing you there are different junction, as I told you early. So these are the different junctions, like you can go for nickel chromium combination, then iron constantin combination. This is known as E type, where iron constantin is known as J type. Then you can go for copper constantin combination. This is known as T type. If I talk about nickel chromium or nickel manganese aluminium, nickel manganese or aluminium silicon, this is known as K type combination. If I go for platinum and rhodium, or any other type, then it is known as R type combination. If I go for platinum or rubidium, then it is known as S type. There are different combinations. Okay. For different combinations, obviously the Seebeck coefficient also getting varied. These are the Seebeck coefficients that is getting varied. For J combination, Seebeck coefficient is equal to 50.2. The unit of Seebeck coefficient is microvolt per degree Celsius. If I talk about T combination, the Seebeck coefficient is equal to 38.0. Okay, 38.0. Okay, fine. So this is the way the Seebeck coefficient is getting varied. Depends on the combination. You have to see the combination accordingly. You can select the Seebeck coefficient. Now I'll be showing you a graph which shows the voltage, that means EMF. This may be EMF. Okay, you can write it as EMF. The EMF versus the temperature. So difference in temperature is shown in the x-axis and the EMF is shown in the y-axis. So with respect to change in temperature, there will be production of EMF. For example, these are the different combinations. Say for first combination, this may be nickel chromium combination. Okay, E combination. And for the second one, it will be iron constant in combination, J type. So it varies. Okay, you can show the linear scale, but some cases it goes non-linear. That's a drawback of thermoelectric transducer. Okay. So these are the relation between the EMF and the temperature, and you can able to see different combination. The graph is different actually. Anyway, some extent it is linear. If it is go beyond the limit, it becomes non-linear. So this is regarding thermoelectric transducer. Okay. And you can able to note on the Seebeck coefficient also. As I told you that Seebeck coefficient will be varied with respect to the particular combination like J type, T type, etc. So there are basically the combination that can be divided into two category. One is base metal. So examples of base metal combination, for example, K, J, E, N and T types are known as base metal combination. Where if I talk about noble metal combination, then platinum, rhodium type S, then platinum, rhodium type R. So these are the different type of noble metal combination. So there are two combinations, base metal combination. Another one will be noble metal combination, base metal and a noble metal combination. Okay. That you have to remember. So this is known as, for example, Nicrose Nissel. That is one of the base metal combination. Okay. The practical availability is plenty available. Okay. You can able to see different practically available thermoelectric transducer. For example, you can say KD810. You can download the data sheet of KD610. So KN820, then KN830. So there are different combinations available. So this is also one of the practically available thermoelectric transducer. So if I talk about the thermoelectric transducer in the skeleton, so let us say that there will be two wires. One is wire A, another will be wire B. Okay, you are going to measure the temperature. So this creates the measuring junction. It creates the measuring junction. See, you can able to see this will be the junction. So the difference in temperature that will be directly proportional to EMF. Okay, you can able to connect with a particular galvanometer, then you will be getting the readings. Okay, definitely it creates two junctions. One is hot junction, another will act as a cold junction. Then normally we prefer stainless steel sheet. Why we should go for stainless steel sheet? Because to prevent the corrosion. So these are the basic information about how it look like. Okay, how it look like. You should have a good idea. Okay, how whether is it available in the market? Of course, it's available, and I have shown some number also. You can remember this number. Okay, this ID you can remember. You can download the data sheets. If you download the data sheets, you will be getting the entire specialty. Now let us come back to pros and cons. What are the major advantages and disadvantages of thermoelectric transducer? If I speak about the advantages, rugged construction, it is cheap, then response time is very fast, and the least stable, it shows high stability for a certain range. It shows stability. Then what I can say, there is a reference is needed and a simple in construction. These are the advantages of thermoelectric transducer. If I talk about the drawback, low accuracy, because you have to calibrate, you have to go for compensation for cold junction, then vulnerable to corrosion. To avoid that, we have to use the stainless steel, that is a bit expensive. Okay, then for accurate measurement, you need to go for compensation. Temperature compensation, you have to go for cold junction. That is also quite expensive. It is very essential. Otherwise, you may be getting the wrong reading. Okay, non-linear behavior for certain range. So these are the pros and cons of thermoelectric transducer. Okay. So what I mentioned is least stable for certain, definitely least stable for what I can say for certain range. So most of the ranges, it will be stable. Okay. Where do you use thermoelectric transducer? For the mainly temperature measurement, you can use it as a radiation sensor. Okay, especially for, you can measure the solar radiation, then gas safety equipments in terms of temperature, the measuring manufacturing industry, steel industry, process industry. So these are the various applications of thermoelectric transducer. Okay. You can list out these applications. It will be helpful for your project also. So in this session, I have discussed about the definition of thermoelectric transducer. It works mainly based on Seebeck effect. Then the basic equation related to the thermoelectric transducer. EMF is equal to minus S into delta T, where S is known as Seebeck coefficient. So Seebeck coefficient will be varied with respect to the junction, J junction, T junction, S junction. I have shown different type of junctions. And even I have shown you the different graph, like voltage versus temperature, how the variations are happening. Okay, that is also I have shown. Then I have shown you the practical availability of thermoelectric transducer and how you are going to measure the temperature in terms of EMF. Okay, that is also I have shown with the help of practical diagrams. At the end, I have discussed about the advantages and disadvantages. Eventually, I could list out a few applications of thermoelectric transducer. If you are having any doubts regarding this topic, do let me know. You can put up the comment in the comment box of this particular video. I'll revert. Finally, thank you for watching this video.